Leading your walk-on Indians, head coach Gene Kling, assistant coach Andy Sires, and assistant coach Dave Schoberlin. And the lineup for your walk-on Indians. At guard, junior number 10, Jordan Snitker Cunningham.
After high school, Jordan attended college at Winona State University, where she received her bachelor's degree in marketing and business administration. After graduating in 2008, Jordan moved to Cedar Rapids, Iowa to begin her so-called grown-up life. In July 2010, she married her high school sweetheart, Sean, and they had their son, Nash, in September 2012. Nash has certainly kept her and Sean on their toes and has been her greatest and most memorable accomplishment since high school. Professionally, she is currently working for Geonetric in the marketing department, where she helps build online solutions for hospitals.
At guard, junior number 12, Vanessa Herman.
Vanessa attended the University of Iowa. There, she completed degrees in marketing and health and sports studies. While at the university, she captained for the University of Iowa cheer squad. She moved to Seattle in 2011 and has been employed with Nordstrom for 4 years, presently as an assistant product merchandiser for women's apparel in Nordstrom Product Group private label brands.
At guard, junior number 14, Carlin Wacker.
After high school, Carlin attended Upper Iowa University. While there, she was an RA, president of Gamma Delta Phi sorority, participated in many other clubs and organizations, and was crowned their homecoming queen. She graduated in 2009 with a degree in art education, graphic design, and a coaching endorsement. She resides in Waukon with her boyfriend Nick and puppy Sassy, where she also teaches the elementary art and tag program in her old stomping grounds. She is currently working towards her master's degree in education. On the side, she owns a graphic design and photography business, Fontan Photo. In her spare time, she enjoys spending time with her family and friends, crafting, sports and recreation, the outdoors, and any entertaining events.
At small forward, junior number 20, Kayla Egan.
After graduating high school, Kayla went to UNI and majored in biology with a minor in Spanish and chemistry. She studied abroad in Spain during the summer of 2007. After graduating from UNI in 2009, Kayla moved to Memphis, Tennessee, where she went to Southern College of Optometry and received her doctorate in optometry in May 2013. While in optometry school, she had the opportunity to go on two mission trips to give free eye exams to those living in Honduras and Mexico. Since graduating, she started practicing in Wilson Eye Care in Waterloo.
At guard, junior number 22, Jessica Ryan Everman.
Jessie graduated from Luther College in 2009, married her best friend Blair Everman, and they bought an acreage south of Waukon all within a few months. The same year, she also studied clinical lab science at St. Luke's Hospital in Cedar Rapids. In May of 2013, she graduated from the University of Wisconsin-Madison PA School and was unbelievably fortunate enough to start her career right here in Waukon. On this January 14th, Blair and Jesse added their biggest life changer to their family, their first child, Weston William.
At small forward, junior number 24, Thea Curtin.
After high school, Thea went to Coe College, where she earned her degree in psychology. She has been working for Tanager Place for 4.5 years, where she serves the community in helping with mental health needs. Thea is also earning her master's degree in mental health counseling, which is why she is unable to be here tonight. Thea resides in Cedar Rapids with her boyfriend Nick, and they have two dogs that keep them pretty busy, Tank the Chocolate Lab and Buck the Beagle. They enjoy being outside and doing whatever they can. Nick is big into hunting and fishing, so naturally he roped Thea into that. She also has been involved in CrossFit for about 2 years and loves being active. She enjoys spending time with family and friends and continues to cherish the bonds that were built throughout the high school years and continue to grow. Congratulations on 10 years, girls and coaches.
At shooting guard, junior number 32, Samantha Reiser.
Sam graduated from the University of Iowa School of Pharmacy in May of 2013 and took a job with Hartig Drug. She was excited for the opportunity to return to the Waukon area and is currently working between Waukon, Prairie du Chien, and Fenimore. She recently got engaged to Ryan Collins and they are getting married this June. Since moving back, she's enjoyed being able to watch her niece and the 7th grade girls' basketball team.
At power forward, senior number 34, Tammy Magner.
After graduation, Tammy completed her Bachelor of Arts degree from Luther College in Physical Education and Health, with a minor in Wellness and Sports Psychology. While there, she played softball for the Norse, and after graduating, she was an assistant coach for the Norse softball program for 1 year. After Luther, she pursued her Master's of Science degree at Western Illinois University in Recreation, Park and Tourism Administration with an emphasis in therapeutic recreation. At WIU, Tammy was also a graduate assistant softball coach for the Leatherneck Athletic Department. After receiving her degree in 2010, she took a position at Beloit College as the promotions coordinator and assistant softball coach in athletics. Once her grant was terminated, she took a position and is currently working at Task in Waukon as a program associate in support services department. She resides in Waukesee with her adorable 3-year-old black Labrador retriever, Chloe. At power forward, junior number 40, Emily Garrett. Emily is currently a third-year medical student at the University of Minnesota in Minneapolis. She will become a doctor and a ball and chain in 2015 when she graduates and weds fiancé Kenneth Williams of Philadelphia. She is looking forward to a career in obstetrics and gynecology, traveling the world, and starting a family. At power forward, junior number 42, Jordan Curtin! In 2009, Jordan graduated from the University of Iowa with a health promotion degree and began her path towards nursing. She completed her Master's of Science in Nursing in 2011 and has been working at the University of Iowa Hospitals and Clinics in the Medical Intensive Care Unit. Jordan often makes it back to Waukon to visit family and is very proud to say that many of her best friends are still the girls from this very team. At center, junior number 44, Stephanie Snitker-Kelly! After high school, Stephanie graduated from Central College, where she met and married her husband, Heath Kelly, and began working as a graphic designer and marketing coach. After their first daughter was born in December 2009, Stephanie decided to stay at home full-time. Although she still keeps up with her design as the marketing and web manager of the family business, Snitker Goldens, she spends most of her time raising their three growing children, Gracelyn, Clayton, and Lillian. Stephanie continues to sing and serve on their church's worship team, stays up to date with walk-on sports, and still enjoys a good game of pickup basketball. She and her family currently live in DeWitt, Iowa. At center, junior number 50, Stephanie Wayner Iverson! After graduation, Stephanie went to Iowa State and has been working on her family dairy farm the past 5 years. In the last couple of years, she also has started helping out at WW Homestead Dairy in Waukon. She married Marshall Iverson in September 2010, and he too is a farmer. On June 4th, 2013, they welcomed their son Hank, who is now 7 months old. At center, senior number 52, Kendra Cook! Kendra lives in Waukon and is currently employed by the Waukon Wellness Center. She has been taking classes to become a physical therapist. She has a great 6-year-old son, Connor, who just started kindergarten this year. He keeps her very busy. At center, senior number 54, Krista Hummel! After high school, Krista attended Upper Iowa University and played D2 basketball for the Peacocks. There, Krista had much personal success as a collegiate athlete. In September of 2011, she welcomed a baby girl to the world, Sophia. Senior manager, Bailey Meyer Benson! Bailey has been married 3 years to her husband, Theron Benson, and they have a 10-month-old daughter, Henley. She is a nurse in Waukon and has worked at Veterans Memorial Hospital for the past 8 years. Sophomore manager, Kayla Knutson-Brown. Since graduating high school in 2006, Kayla attended pharmacy school at Drake and graduated from there in 2012. She got married to her husband, Donald, in 2010, and they have a baby, Beagle that is, named Penny. Now Kayla is currently living and working at Medicat Pharmacy in Madrid, Iowa. Sophomore manager, Amy Harvey. After high school, Amy went to Iowa State University and got a degree in biology. During undergrad, she moved to New Zealand for 6 months to study abroad. She is currently a student doctor at Southern College of Optometry and graduates this May. She's on externship rotations right now and traveling the country, but originally lives in Gunnison, Colorado. Amy is engaged to Dr. Justin Atherton, who is also an optometrist. Sophomore cheerleader, Samantha Earhart. After graduation in 2006, Sam attended Kirkwood and studied agriculture, then transferred to Iowa State for agricultural studies. Since graduating from ISU, she's been active in the agricultural community. Sam currently made a career change, accepting the position of regional manager for the Farm Bureau Federation in Northeast Iowa and is excited to move to Farmersburg. She will be getting married to Randy Wagner this June. Junior cheerleader Morgan Lyons. Morgan is currently living in West Des Moines and is working towards graduating in May with her doctorate in nursing practice and family nurse practitioner degree. She graduated with her nursing degree from Mount Mercy College back in 2009. Morgan is also getting married this June to Kyle Olson. Sophomore cheerleader Sierra Marr. Sierra graduated from the University of Northern Iowa with a major in elementary education. She lived in Austin, Texas while student teaching and landed a job in the Almaquin Community School District after moving back to Waukon in 2011. She is in her third year at East Elementary and currently teaches sixth grade. Junior cheerleader Jody Sweeney Eglin. After graduating, Jody attended college and graduated from UNI in May 2009. She also went to the Worldwide College of Auctioneering in June 2007, and for the last 4 years, she's been back in Northeast Iowa working full-time with her family's auction company, which she loves. A highlight in this career path has been winning the Women's International Auctioneer Championship in 2008. Jody also has specialized as a benefit auctioneer and travels across Iowa conducting charity auctions, as well as being a real estate sales associate in Waukon. In September 2011, she married her husband, Dustin Eglin, and they live near Austin. Senior cheerleader, Lori Wild. Lori graduated with her bachelor's degree in communication and journalism from the University of Northern Iowa, and then her master's degree in mass communication, also from UNI. She spent a year working in athletic communications at UNI before moving back to the area, and now works at WQPC Q94 Radio in Prairie du Chien as an account executive and hosts the afternoon show on Q94. Lori currently lives in Fenimore, Wisconsin, with the lovely man Dustin. Senior cheerleader Ashley Wilder. After graduating from Coke College in 2008, Ashley moved to Cedar Falls for a job offer and is still currently at Distech Integration Incorporated, a small company that does test and automation solutions for off-highway vehicles. Recently, Ashley purchased a home south of Waterloo, Cedar Falls, and added an adorable black lab named Zoe to the family. Just over the holidays, she got engaged to her now fiancé, Luke.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence, but committed no crime.
It really doesn't seem like it's in this big of a gym. It seems like we're back home playing.
I'd say we're the Cinderella team this year. Last year we ended up okay. We did about 18-5 or so. But this year, it's like whole new story. Nobody's heard of us, but we're 25-0 and now we're 26-0.
Starters being introduced to the crowd right now here at Bet's Auditorium. Let's give them to you. First of all, for the Indians of Waukon under Gene Kling, 26-0. It's over. A heartbreaking loss for Atlantic. Waukon is into the championship game.
We just told the kids at the timeout before that you got to cover Jenkins because she's the three-point threat. She's the best three-point shooter. And we knew the play that they were going to run and everything. And we still, I don't know if we got anybody there to cover or not, but we did. Emily did play through the screen, and she might have hurried her a little bit. I think our kids were very tired, too. We didn't get probably as much rest as we needed to, getting them out and getting. But they played hard right through the end, and I was awfully proud of the comeback that they had. Our kids have been survivors, and we've been not that late in the ball game, been down that much, but we've been down before, and they've been able to find a way, and they came over, and they were pretty down. I said, it's not the end of the world, but it's just keep fighting and playing hard. And I said, I know you girls, you've worked too hard to get where you're at, and I just know that you'll find a way to win it. And somehow they did.
Now, but the last 3-2-1. It is official now. Waukon is the state 3A basketball champion.
Hard, and we really work together as a team. This is awesome. Our team is just so happy, and we're proud that we've done this, because this is what our goal was at the beginning of the season, and we finally accomplished it.
It's dream come true. Pretty much sums it up, I guess. So. That, and it's unbelievable. I still can't believe it. All I know is I've been waiting for this ever since 7th grade, our first year when I defeated, and just
always thought we'd make it here since then, but never thought it'd be like this.
It's like the greatest feeling I've ever had. It's the best way to go out of my senior year, is to go out with a state championship.
I've really always, my coaching career, wanted to have a team that could press for 32 minutes, man-to-man pressure, and still fast break and go, go, go. And this group is as close to being that as any I've ever had.
We're just an amazing bunch of girls. We've worked so hard throughout the season, throughout our whole high school and junior high careers.
It's amazing. We couldn't have done anything without our team. The girls have been so supportive. It's like a euphoria. We're just like on the top of the world. It's amazing.
You know, we wanted to end our senior year with the state championship, and we wanted to give that to Coach because he's worked so many years so hard that he never had a state championship, and that's what we wanted to give him.
The fact that our girls, I told them when they were rated at the beginning of the season at fourth, I said, I think you're too high there, and we discussed it a little bit, and I said, but if they think that we're fourth best team in the state, I said, let's try to prove it and stay there as long as we can. And then the teams ahead of us started getting dumped, so I think from about the third rating on, we were ranked number one. And that really does put a lot of pressure on kids, and I thought it put a lot of pressure on us, but they handled it really well. They didn't seem to shake them at all, and they just took them one game at a time, and not every group can do that. Girls, I'm so proud of you. I don't know what else to tell you. It's just, it's been a fabulous ride. It's been a fabulous run for me and the coaches. And
very much so.
Just a thrill. You're just a great bunch of kids. Just great. It's just done a fabulous job.